Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. My name is George and you're watching Just Shake or Steer with another Sunday series of homemade ingredients. And today we're making a grenadine. So first I'm gonna put my pot on the stove and start warming it up. And when I do these things, I'm gonna explain a few things to you about the grenadine. But we're gonna start with half a liter of grenadine, 100% grenadine juice. And I will explain this, but because I need to reduce this juice, let me put it first in the pot. That's it. So when I chat to you, I'm gonna start reducing this. And there you go. So you can make grenadine from the fresh pomegranate, okay? It's absolutely fine. If you're fancy to get a few pomegranates and do a cold press or clean them, you know, proper, and then just boil them with water, it's your call. First of all, it's a bit more expensive, and second, it's taking a more time, and depends of the season, you may not get proper pomegranate with lots of juice inside and good flavor. So the best solution here is to go and grab yourself a pomegranate juice ready made for you. All you need to do is reduce it and then create the grenadine. However, when you're buying this juice, make sure you get 100% cold press or made from 100% fruit, no concentrate, okay? Do not buy concentrate, because in this case, you better just go and buy your grenadine from the shop and you don't make it, okay? So this is, I'm using Krubicon here. It doesn't matter which company it is, but this is made from 100% real fruits. There's no any artificial colors or anything, and there's no any concentration. It's 100% fruit, okay? So many other channels did the grenadine and all of them, it's fantastic, and I watch these channels and I love them, like for example Steve the Bartender or Truffle on Rocks or the Educated Barfly. And if you watch these guys, I'll leave link in the description. So if you don't, go make sure you subscribe to them, because they bring some cool stuff as well. And also you'll see every one of them have their own take on the grenadine. And this is the cool things about bartending and mixology, that we are like a chefs. All of us follow the basics, but we have our own kind of a twist how to make the final syrups or cocktails or whatever we do. Now, this is start boiling, so I'm gonna keep it on medium heat. Just want them to reduce. This may take time, so I'm gonna cut the video. But half a liter I'm using today, not liter, half a liter, and I'll try to reduce to 250 ml, hopefully, okay? So all you need is the pomegranate juice. You need some orange flower, orange blossom flower water, or in my case, I like to use orange blossom dry flowers. You can buy them on internet. I'll try to leave link in the description, depends what I found, if it's available for you. But when you have them dry, you can keep them for a longer, and this way you can create your own orange blossom water, or you can just use them as they are dry. Also, we're gonna use some hibiscus flowers. The hibiscus flowers is basically to bring more red rich color to the grenadine. Excuse me. They won't bring any flavor. They have a little, they don't have any smell. The flavor, it may be just a little bit floral, but the pomegranate is gonna overwhelm this flavor, so you won't even feel it. The orange blossom, it's fantastic inside. And finally, we're gonna drop a little bit of lemon to increase the tartness of the grenadine. So this is boiling here. Make sure you leave it to reduce halfway through before you put the sugar. So I will be back when this is halfway reduced and ready. Okay, we're nearly there. So what I'm gonna do now is add the hibiscus. I don't want it to cook from the beginning because I want it to reduce, obviously, the juice. Now, there's no wrong or right what how much hibiscus you can put. Usually I get like a full hunt of dry flowers, and I just put them inside. And also, in many cases, if you watch other recipes, you see they use orange blossom water, like I mentioned in the beginning, because it's already made and it's already bottled. You can put it in the very end, but I'm using orange blossom flowers. And I have like a half a shot glass here. Just gonna drop the orange blossom flowers as well inside and give it a good stir with a bamboo straw. Yeah, why not? You expect me to have a proper wooden spoon, but I left it in my kitchen, so I'm just gonna use the bamboo straw. And now I'm gonna leave this to cook for probably another 10 minutes or 15 to reduce proper. And then we're gonna add the sugar and we're gonna make our lovely grenadine, okay? I'll see you soon. Okay, we're nearly ready. It smells fantastic. You have this lovely from the orange blossom flower smell, and the pomegranate is just, it's beautiful. Right, I'm gonna put the heat down now. And what we have to do at this moment of time is get our jar back, put a fine sieve on top of it, and strain it, because we don't want any hibiscus or orange blossom inside in the grenadine. Yeah, we want just the juice. And there you go. Now it's reduced to, how much is it? 300 ml. Nearly there, yeah, it should be 250 if you're following all the way down, but it's not a big deal for 50 ml more, because we're gonna add the sugar and we're gonna create our grenadine. Let me just get all the flowers and hibiscus out. We're gonna make a, I'm gonna fine sift after as well once more, but just in case. And here we go, we have it here. Just wanted to show you the difference. Let me just grab a glass. So this is the juice when we start. So I hope you can see it. I'll try to bring it forward. Now there you go. You see the juice, how bright red it is, and you see now your grenadine with the hibiscus flowers. It's bright, dark red, proper, lovely color. And when we put the sugar and make the texture more thick, we're gonna have fantastic grenadine. So we're gonna put back. And this time, we don't need to boil it, okay? All we need to do is just a medium heat. Just get, because it's messy, 250 to 300 grams of white sugar. Go inside. And now what you need to do, it's like a few minutes just to help the sugar to dissolve, of course, and then we have to leave it to cool down for a while before we bottling, okay? So I'll see you again when it's ready. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, our grenadine, it's ready. So what happened is when I took a break to cut this video, I've reduced a little bit more the liquid, and obviously I add 250 grams of sugar, dissolve it, and I leave it on the side for a half an hour to cool down, because you don't want to bottle it when it's very, very warm. So this is it. I have here 250 ml of a grenadine. I gone a little bit over, around 300 ml, so I left a little bit on the side to use it, but before I bottle it, actually let's bottle it and I'll show you after. So all you need, it's a funnel, there's no any more hibiscus inside, orange blossoms, nothing. So we're just gonna bottle, and look at that beautiful red thick color, it's just fantastic. And there you go. We all ready. A homemade fantastic grenadine, perfect for your cocktails. And just again, just to show you the difference. This is start from the juice, 100% juice, remember, don't take any concentrates. Then reduce, if you're doing a liter, reduce to half. If you're doing half a liter, to 250, 300 ml. Add a handful of hibiscus flower, orange blossom. If you're using dry, add around like a small half a shot or a small espresso cup inside. If you get yourself a orange blossom water, just add around 20 ml inside. When the syrup is already done, you can add. And finally, a fresh squeezed lemon juice. You don't need much, you need around maybe 10 to 15 ml. So not really much. This is just gonna bring a little bit more of tartness to the syrup. And here we go. Close it. Give it a little shake, like a very gentle. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Fantastic grenadine. So what else left to do? We have to give them a try. Oh, I can just drink it like that. Beautiful, rich red color with a lot of tartness and a wonderful sweetness coming from the grenadine. And this is it, guys. Once again, thank you for watching. Just Shake or Steer. My name is George. If you're new to the channel, welcome. And I hope you're gonna hit this subscribe button. Give us a like, thumbs up, leave it a comment. Yeah, everything helps to make the channel growing and getting bigger and bigger, hopefully soon. However, I'm still here, nothing's gonna stop me, and I'm gonna still bring cocktails to you and every Sunday homemade ingredients. So if you miss anything, check the card and check the raspberry syrup, which I did last weekend, which is fantastic. I'm gonna bring some cocktails with it. But for now, yeah, enjoy whatever you do and have a wonderful week ahead. Don't forget, subscribe and like. It's much appreciated. And yeah, I mentioned before I have Patreon page, which I'm still not figured out how to work out. So probably I'm gonna bring it in another videos, but yeah, I'll leave you now. Go make some grenadine, make some cocktails, mix some tequila sunrise. Enjoy the summer. See ya, bye bye.